Hi, welcome to my show. Today my guest is Brian Boulus. And I met Brian, I don't even think it's been a week yet, has it? I was giving a talk at Shlomo Foundation cultural event. And I was busy setting up my table with my books, and I was hearing this very beautiful classical Arabic music from songs from like very old songs that are very dear to anybody who's been born in the Middle East. They're very dear to them. And I wasn't even sure, I didn't even know that there was a person actually playing it. I thought it was not a DJ, but you know, like some kind of a music box or something. And I remember that when I turned around, I saw a very young person playing the oud, and not only that, singing in the original, the Arabic language. I was really touched by just how good he was playing, but the fact that he was young. And then I went and I approached him, and I said, you know, were you born here or are you new? And he said, yes. And then I was more impressed because I know a lot of times kids, including mine, it's hard to teach them a second language. And so I said, you know, I really would love to have you come on my show and play some of these, the musical songs that you're playing. So welcome, Brian. Thank you so much for coming on my show.
Thank you.
And giving us and my audience the opportunity to listen to your wonderful music.
Thank you.
So what I would like to know, and I got to meet, by the way, I got to meet his mom outside. Oh my God, what a love. And it's kind of now I understand why he grew up like this. So he has a wonderful, very smart mom, because she was telling me what her values are and how she supported him when he decided what the music instrument that he wanted to play, and how just she's very supportive, very wise. And she told me some of the stories on how you started playing the oud, and also how she taught you Arabic. So can you share these stories with us, since I can't bring her here?
Well, I remember when I was young, I shoveled snow around 10 years old, had enough money to go to Borders and buy an Arabic book and learned right away, you know, from my youth. And I'd heard songs from my mom on the car, you know, car radio, and she played George Wasuf songs, Umm Kulthum songs, and I hear the oud in the background. I fell in love with it right away, and so that's what got me to learn oud, you know. Mm-hmm. We went to Tasjilat al-Rabi', spring recordings.
Yes.
On the Quender, and
yes,
they gave us their number, Karim Badr's number, my teacher. Yeah.
Oh, so you ended up getting a teacher?
Yeah.
Okay.
My teacher is Karim Badr.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and that's how I learned. I learned when I was 12, and stick with them for a couple years to learn. And
I think she said, she mentioned something that I think it was either, whether in Christmas or your birthday, is that the first time that you got an oud?
Yeah, went to Dearborn to get an oud, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's really great that you had like such a supportive mom, because a lot of times, you know, with musicians or people in the creative field, they don't find that support. So you're very lucky in that aspect.
Yeah.
And so today I asked you who you wanted to come, like what you wanted to play.
Right.
And so you chose two very famous singers, especially with Abdul Halim Hafez. He was more universal. He's Egyptian. Well, everybody loved him.
Yep.
He unfortunately he died at a fairly young age, at the age of 48 in London, of liver failure. But I do have a little clip here of him, and this is not the same song that you're going to be playing, but it just at least gives audience the idea of who this is. Let's see.
Thank you. واتمنى لو انساك وانت روحي وياك كن ضاعت يبقى فداك لو تنساني وانساك وتريني بنسى جفاك واشتاق لعذابي معاك والادموع فاكراك ارجع تاني في لقاك الدنيا تجيني معاك ورضاها يبقى رضاك وساعتها يهون في هواك في هواك طول حرماني واتمنى لو انساك وانسى روحي وياك وان ضاعت تبقى فداك لو تنساني وانساك وتريني بنسى جفاك واشتاق لعذابي معاك والادموع يفكرك ارجع تاني في لقاك الدنيا تجيني معاك ورضاها يبقى رضاك ساعتها هيهون في هواك في هواك طول حرمان ولاقيك مشغول وشاغلني بيك وعنيا تيجي فعنيك وكلامهم يبقى عليك وانت الداري ورايك واصحى من الليل اناديك وابعت روحي تصحيك قوم ياللي شاغلني بيك جرب ناري الاقيك مشغول وشاغلني بيك وعنيا تيجي فعنيك وكلامهم يبقى عليك وانت الداري ورايك واصحى من الليل اناديك وابعت روحي تصحيك امي اللي شاغلني بيك جرب ناري الاقيك مشغول وشاغلني بيك وعنيا تيجي فعنيك وكلامهم يبقى عليك وانت الداري ورايك واصحى من الليل اناديك وابعت روحي تصحيك امي اللي شاغلني بيك جرب ناري واتمنى لو انساك وانسى روحي وياك وان ضاعت يبقى فداك لو تنساني وانساك وتريني بنسى جفاك واشتاق لعذابي معاك والادموع يفكرك ارجع تاني في لقاك الدنيا تجيني معاك ورضاها يبقى رضاك ساعتها يهون في هواك في هواك طول حرماني
Oh my gosh, I love that so much. It brings up so many memories. And, you know, I was just going to, it's not that long, it's actually just 4 minutes, but I was not going to originally play the whole thing. But then when it was playing, the reason I kept it going is because, you know, if you notice, aside from his singing and everything, but even the acting during that time and just that whole world in the Middle East, there's such good memories with regards to the arts and culture and the films. There was such a deep creative aspect, and so that's another reason why I just like the fact that you chose, you resonated with that. Somebody who's born here, you resonated with something that was very, very rich. Abdul Halim Hafiz was just like the Elvis of here, of the United States, with him playing the romantic songs. And I have a little clip, a very short clip of his funeral where, you know how in the Middle East the numbers vary. So some people say there was like hundreds of thousands of people that attended the funeral. And some actually say that it was millions. So I don't know which one to believe. But the point is, it was an incredibly big thing when he passed away. And here's a small clip of that. Right. It was even claimed that there was a number of women that had actually committed suicide. They killed themselves over balconies after they heard that he had passed away. And so here we are, you know, like 40 years, well, more than 40 years later, and we're mm-hmm. still impacted by him, so that a young person in the United States can choose to sing his song. So go ahead, and we're ready if you are. I would love to hear sure. some of that music.
Start with a small taqasim, like introduction, and then go with the song. Thank you.
so much. That was so beautiful.
Thank you.
Well, again, I am so grateful that you came and so that you can share this. And like that day when I saw you, I felt like more people need to hear. So this is great. Another person, if you want to tell me a little bit, I actually had a harder time finding information on the second person that you're going to be playing. And that's because he's mostly, his work was mostly recognized in Iraq.
He's a musician, composer.
He's a composer.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I just ended up learning something from you. Okay, so Ghanem Haddad.
Ghanem Haddad,
yes,
yep.
And he was born in 1925 in Baghdad. His work was mostly for the radio. And I have a little bit of a clip for him before you start playing his music. Right here. I know that you're gonna do another song right now.
Right.
Okay, but go ahead.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, what I'm curious now, we have literally 2 minutes left, unfortunately, because we spent it on the music, but I would love to hear, where do you plan to go with your music?
Just perform as much as I can for occasions and keep practicing, doing what I love, you know.
So you want to continue this, obviously, to grow in it, yeah.
And open to any kind of opportunity.
Yes. And so how can people, what's the best way for people to get a hold of you?
They could look up Oud Player in Michigan on Facebook. That's my business page. Oud Player in Michigan.
Oud Player Michigan?
Oud Player in Michigan.
Oud Player in Michigan. Can you spell that again, please?
Oud Player in Michigan.
Okay,
Facebook
great.
Business page.
Okay, great. And then what I'll do is I'll also, when I post this, I wish I would have put this under your name, but when I post it on my website, I'll make sure to put that information in. Yeah, so... take advantage of bringing him to your events. I mean, it's really beautiful music, especially if you have a Middle Eastern background. Well, again, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
It was great, and I hope that I can continue to have the pleasure of hearing you live, okay?
No problem.
Take care.